Yeah, I mean, part of this is that we're going to have to wait and see, right? We've heard Elon talk about Grok 4 and how great it's going to be and how it's equivalent of every PhD student ever in the world combined and is smarter than that, right? But until you really get your hands on these things, it's hard to say. What I will say is the timing is interesting. You saw this week that the version of Grok that we have right now, Grok 3, was spewing this anti-Semitic stuff. And I think what that tells me is that no matter how good these chatbots get in terms of the technology, it still really depends on how they're trained and who is sort of filling the information into these bots, right? Because Grok 4 could be the most advanced thing of all time. If it's spewing anti-Semitic comments to users on X, it really doesn't matter, right? And so to me, we need to sort of wait and see. I realize that's a bit of an unfulfilling answer to this question, but it's just too early. And all we have right now is sort of Elon's praise for the bot to go off of.
Grok also coming to a Tesla soon near you. This is what Elon Musk said too. So what is that? Like, is that just
Yeah.
giving more data to Grok? I don't know. What's that connection? I guess I get it on some level because
Sure.
it's the Elon universe, but what is that?
I was going to say, like, the Elon universe is like this ever morphing, melding thing. We've talked about the three of us have talked about this before, but like this idea that one corner of his universe just kind of gets pulled into the other, this is pretty common. So I'm not surprised, but this is how I'm thinking of it. And again, new information like this can all evolve, but hands free, right? Like the idea that you maybe you're already using self-driving, but let's pretend you're doing it the old-fashioned way. You're driving yourself around. And you want to safely, figure out the best route to where you're headed. You need to ask about a headline you thought about earlier. You want to make a call. Like, you want a voice assistant that is ultimately high quality that's going to be able to do all those things safely, right? So maybe in a perfect world, Grok serves as your co-passenger, your co-pilot here on a trip, so that you're not like pulling out your phone or tinkering with the screen in the Tesla. Now, I think a lot of this is sort of idealistic because we need to see how this is implemented. And also, again, like how good is Grok? Is it reliable enough to do those types of things? But I think in the perfect world, imagine it as the hands-free co-pilot there for you in your car.
Well, if you bring up the point about some of the challenges that Grok 3 has had, that has been well documented in terms of coming up with anti-Semitic posts and the like on X and sort of what we've seen shared out there, Kurt. How do we know if Grok 4 or how does XAI solve this if it hasn't really solved this for Grok 3?
Yeah, and I think that's sort of the challenge, and I think the issue too is like the anti-Semitic comments that came out of Grok 3, those happened just over the last couple of days. Grok 3 has been out for months before that, right? But there was a tweak. Elon was talking about like a tweak to the chatbot, and all of a sudden it's now, sharing these really horrible posts. And so these things can evolve very quickly, depending on, again, what type of information is put into it, what type of guardrails are in place for how these bots should or should not respond. So I'm certainly not in a position where I'm like, oh, they fixed it. Grok 4 is going to go off without a hitch. I think the timing of the incidents they had with Grok 3 right before this rollout actually make me much more skeptical about Grok 4. But again, we sort of need to wait and see. They clearly, at the very least, acknowledge that that was a problem, right? Sometimes they've had issues and they just kind of refused to even acknowledge the issue. In this case, they acknowledged, hey, this was inappropriate. These types of answers should not have been coming. I know that's the bar is incredibly low, guys, but I take that as a good sign.
I'm wondering, Kurt, that Elon's time in the government and Doge, how much, like, can we make any assumption that there was information and data that he had access to that is kind of going into Grok? Will we ever
Ooh, good
even
question.
know?
It's a great question. It's one we've been all asking about actually for months. There was this idea, you may remember, when he asked employees of the government to basically say, hey, here are the five things I did this week, right? Like basically justify your job. Send us an email with what you did. There was speculation around that time that the only way to really sift through thousands and thousands of emails of a list of five accomplishments was to rely on AI. Now, as far as I know, there was no reporting that sort of confirmed, hey, Grok was being used, or that certainly sensitive government information was being put into Grok, or that Grok was being trained on that type of stuff. But again, there was a lot of speculation, given what Elon does, given his focus on this AI, that maybe it was used behind the scenes to sort of help with some of these tasks, maybe help with where cuts should be coming from or not coming from. I don't recall, again, that ever being confirmed with reporting, but I think you're asking the question that a lot of us have been asking for months now, was there a relationship there beyond, just the way anyone could use it publicly, right?